The idea behind Clockwork Empires is fantastic. A city-building sim that incorporates elements of Lovecraftian weirdness and steampunk aesthetics. In practice, it makes for a serviceable simulator, but one that could use a bit more grease in its gears. Its stranger elements can make for fun meta-stories late in a game. But one of Clockwork Empire's main issues is that it takes a bit too long to get ticking. The text-based tutorial explains the basics of assigning overseers to tasks and building more houses to grow your population well enough. But it's less adept at explaining the finer points of its user interface, which feels increasingly unwieldy as scenarios progress. It's also sometimes a challenge to control the colonists and keep them on task. They have Sims-like wants and dislikes, but the spotty AI still sometimes leaves them ignoring key assignments or visibly hiccuping as they plan their next actions when shifted to 2x speed. There's no multiplayer mode, but there is a good variety of single-player challenges on hand since Clockwork Empires lets you choose from multiple biomes with different starting conditions at the beginning. Unfortunately, regardless of biome, the randomization of the map means you almost always find yourself in a patently unsuitable place, littered with scattershot resources, where much of the first half hour or more will be spent suffering through the tedium of clearing and flattening land. Much of its appeal lies in the setting, which casts you as the leader of colonists for a far-flung steampunk empire. Unfortunately, the steampunk art style isn't quite so strong as the name Clockwork Empires might lead you to think, being chiefly limited to decorative details and the ability to make clockwork knights. But Clockwork Empires manages to mold a memorable personality for itself by sometimes weaving in Lovecraftian disturbances that code an otherwise predictable setup and pleasing weirdness. The music maintains this mood well, particularly when it takes on creepy tones at night as settlers rest uneasily in their beds, and the little details of the decor help capture some of those steampunk sensibilities. Most of the time, though, it's just a little too normal. It certainly doesn't help that the pacing is slow as a whole, with long stretches passing by with nothing significant happening, even when using the option to double the game speed. That's partly because its Lovecraftian elements also don't always shake things up like they should. In one attempt, the horror-themed events were so rare that for hours the only real horror was the mundane worry of trying to make enough food to feed everyone. Other attempts balanced them better, but never quite enough to offset the annoyances of the AI and the user interface. For more on Clockwork Empires, stick with IGN.